Hello, and welcome to our supplemental video for infant brain imaging using magnetoencephalography, challenges, solutions, and best practices. We thought it would be helpful to provide an example of a real infant testing session in the iLabs MEG Center. The MEG data acquisition process requires a number of carefully executed steps to obtain good quality brain data. These steps include system setup, acquisition setup, and preparation of the participant. In this video, we will show how we adapted this acquisition process to accommodate infant participants. To prepare for the family's arrival, we set up everything ahead of time. Efficiency is critical when working with infants. The preparation area is set up with a high chair and MEG-compatible toys. Here we see the essential items laid out in a way that makes them easily accessible to the technician during the appointment. Items include infant caps in a variety of sizes, HPI coils, electrodes, tape, and a foam ring that is used to protect the baby's head. Inside the MSR, it's important to have a setup that is comfortable for the infant. It's also very important to have an area where the research assistant stands and engages the infant's attention using toys. Our adult MEG chair can be adjusted easily to make it suitable for infants. We have chairs to accommodate all sizes, from young infants to adults. Here, we added an infant seat angled so that the head is properly positioned inside the helmet. This position not only provides a comfortable seat for the infant, but also allows for good signal-to-noise ratio in the MEG. We have pillows and blankets that help support the infant. After the family's arrival, we check those who will be entering the MSR for ferrous material. We have the parent, infant, and staff member move close to the sensors while the technician checks for any interference. If there is interference, we have parent and infant change into metal-free clothing. Once the family is ready, the parent places the infant into the high chair for digitization. A trained assistant acts as a toy waiver to engage the infant throughout the rest of the appointment. The toy waiver safely straps the infant into the chair and directs the parent to sit nearby, but out of sight. The toy waiver begins to entertain the baby using toys, and the infant becomes familiar with this new person. The technician measures the infant's head in order to choose the cap that best fits the infant. The technician then selects a cap and begins to attach the HPI coils with medical tape before placing it on the infant's head.
Shake it, shake, shake. Shake it, shake, shake. Nope. Oh, you want both of them. You want two toys? Two toys? Wow.
While placing the cap on the infant's head, the technician tries to stay out of the infant's view and does not engage in play so that the infant pays attention to the toy waiver.
Up, and down. Up, and down.
The digitization process is especially important for infants. Good representation of the head shape, as well as accurate digitization of cardinal points in the HPI coils, are essential for accurate source modeling. Here, the technician is digitizing the cardinal points using the Polhemus device. Note that the cap allows for the ears to be exposed so the technician can properly access the cardinal points. The technician also digitizes the location of each HPI coil and additional points along the surface of the infant's head.
Looks like a telephone. Hello? Hello?
We want to capture as many additional points as possible while the infant is still happy and compliant. We suggest getting a minimum of about 200 points.
It's loud. Here's one.
Ooh. Once finished, the technician writes detailed notes about the digitization process. Now the technician places the EOG and ECG electrodes on the infant. Electrode placement is important for good signal quality. We also want to make sure the infant can't tear off the electrodes during the measurement. We place two EOG electrodes on the infant, one slightly below the eye and the other near the orbital rim above the opposite eye. This allows us to capture both blinks and saccades while minimizing the number of electrodes. We place ECG electrodes on the chest and on the back of the infant to measure the electrical signals emanating from the heart.
Almost there, you're doing so great.
Once the electrodes are placed, we put a soft foam ring on the infant's head to protect it from bumping against the inside of the MEG helmet. Now the infant is ready to be taken into the MSR. The toy waiver and the technician then lead the parent, who carries the baby, into the MSR. We have lots of MEG safe toys placed so that they are easily accessed by the toy waiver. We place a chair alongside the MEG out of the infant's view for the parent to sit so they can be present during the MEG session. The toy waiver straps the infant into the chair securely. We use Velcro straps so the size can be easily adapted for each child without needing to make time-consuming adjustments. Once the infant is seated comfortably in the MEG chair, the infant is adjusted so that the baby's head is in an ideal position inside the MEG helmet. The toy waiver strategically selects toys and attracts the infant's gaze so that the baby's head can be properly adjusted. In this video, we show an example of a study using a passive auditory paradigm. Sounds are presented over the loudspeaker inside the MSR. The toy waiver pantomimes and chooses silent toys that won't interfere with the auditory stimuli. In some studies, we also use a silent video to keep the baby calm and attentive. The toy waiver needs to gauge the pace of entertainment based on the infant's reaction and level of restlessness. It's not as easy as it looks. Often it makes sense to begin with the least interesting toys. Later, the toy waiver has to ramp it up and use more exciting toys to keep the baby engaged. Here you see the infant holding and interacting with a toy. The use of toys and how they are deployed as a method of keeping the infant alert and calm must be adapted to the specific paradigm and the individual infant. And for example, when we conduct a somatosensory MEG study, touching the infant or allowing the infant to hold a toy is avoided during trials. Sometimes less is more with regard to toy waving. The infant's attention can sometimes be captivated by a single toy for a long period of time. Other times, the toy waiver will cycle through many toys throughout the session to keep the infant attentive and still. This is largely dependent on the age group and the individual personality of the infant. You can see that the infant is able to move freely within the helmet during the MEG session. Our software allows us to easily compensate for the infant's movement during the pre-processing stage of data analysis using movement compensation algorithms. Outside the MSR, the technician constantly monitors the sensors, the infant's behavior, the baby's head position in the helmet, and takes detailed notes on the testing session. As is the case for all data collection procedures involving young infants, practice makes perfect.